Let me know when you're going.
Hello, Twitch. By special request by Cheddars here, he did not want me to do the slides at the beginning here, so I'll skip those this week. And he just wanted to monologue, I guess, to you about his awesome face.
Exactly. You know, we've got all these wonderful visitors here, and we're so thankful for everyone who's joining on this Twitch stream, and we're thankful so much for all the support that people have given, both through their comments, through their interaction, through the way that they interact with Twitch, by joining the Discord, by hanging out with us and asking really good questions, especially during those QA sessions. And it's been so fun to be able to be such a large community, you know, Altspace VR, VR chat, all these, you know, Final Fantasy 14, Rust, have all of you be able to participate through Twitch has been so reassuring, you know. And it's just like, if you have the opportunity, I'd love to meet you guys in Altspace VR and have a wonderful conversation and show you around, maybe do a little bit of world hopping after service and showing you what kind of worlds Altspace has. But it's been amazing and such a blessing to fellowship, to pray with one another, and to know all of you. So thank you for being a part of Twitch. Thank you so much for being a part of VRMO Church, and thank you so much for all that you do. May God bless all of you richly, as I always say at the end of announcements, and may you continue to pursue God in all his glory and unfathomable riches, and be able to put your hope and rest in him. I really want you guys to realize how good God is. Anyways, I should probably get to welcoming people now that people are joining the world. So have fun enjoying the service, Twitch.
Yes, and you have fun hosting there.
Will do.
That was very well said. I like how that came out there where people were joining in as he was talking to. That was kind of cool. So I'm going to enable Fly.
So we've got right Alice, Alice.
And I haven't actually looked around the world yet, so I really don't know what to expect. I usually look around just a little bit before streaming, but I got caught up talking. So me? No, never. Okay, so yep, we got a few people down here. Got Lena down there. Chris. Who's this? Don't recognize them. Steven. I think I've seen them here before, maybe. Steven sounds familiar. Got Octane over here. And don't mind background noise. Oh yeah, that's another thing too. I had to disable the option for noise removal on my headphones, so there might be a little bit more noticeable background noise. Let me know if it's too much, but it's I'll try to get some of that quiet down. It was causing an issue when I was muting my microphone with that buzzing sound, so I thought it was...
Hello everybody, welcome to VR Church. We started in a couple of minutes. Looking forward to church service today. Feel free to invite your friends.
Yeah, I thought it was a voice meter or audio engine problem. It was not. It was the Logitech software. So I got that fixed today. Got it fixed for a friend as well. That's actually what kind of pushed me a little more to fix it. And hopefully we won't have that buzzing issue anymore. Actually, this is the friend right here that I fixed that issue for that I was just talking about. Dan the man. Talking about my microphone issues that we had earlier today.
It's been a while. Oh. I
that's working
I
well for
had
you?
Any buzzing stuff happened to me, so.
Okay.
I meant to go to the...
It's good.
All's good.
One, hopefully that all stays straight. Good amount of people here today. Get a good look here.
We have a friend named Alice in the UK.
Got Jaden, Jess, Frey, Chat for Green,
from the UK.
VR Tiger, that's a cool name. Yeah. Linda and I. Eric up on one of the floating islands. For some reason, when I'm sprinting, the audio sounds a little, like, stretched. So I try not to sprint too much. What a beautiful world this is, too, that was built. Very abstract. You guys have anything exciting going on this week? Oh, Crystal's got a bit of a headache. Hope you get better there.
may ask if Mr. Pete is in the house. What better way than to start off this wonderful service with a word of prayer? And at the moment, I don't see him, so I'll go ahead and lead us in a word of prayer, since he might be in room two. Anyways, thank you, God, for your wonderful, powerful, precious, almighty name, and for all that you've done for us, for dying on the cross for our sins, so that we may be able to live in your righteousness and eternal life. We ask, God, that you would help us to humble ourselves, to realize that you are God and we are, you know, people that you love. Help us to open our hearts to what the pastor has to say during this wonderful sermon. In your powerful, precious name, Jesus Christ, God, the Father, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So, everybody here is welcome at Virtual Reality Church. Doesn't matter if you believe in God or not, we appreciate everyone from all kinds of backgrounds. Now, on October 12th of last year, we switched over to season 5 of VRMO Church, where we want to no longer build this plane while we're flying it. Habakkuk 2:2 is a great rallying call for us to write the vision and engrave it plainly on tablets so that the one who reads it will run. This means we're concentrating on 4 churches: Final Fantasy T14 Online, Rust, VR Chat, and this Altspace Metaverse. With another season of change comes a new focus, which is good works. It is great to have religious knowledge and events, but that is not enough. We want everyone here to be known for your good works that express God's love to others. It is as simple as pray, give, and go. Pray with us in the Discord channel. Give of your heart, mind, time, finances, and abilities, and go to support, encourage, comfort, and love others, like in our community channels. If you are wondering what the vision is for VRMMO Church, it is to cultivate loving spiritual communities across the metaverse. That has been the heartbeat of VRMMO Church. To support this, there are now many community channels that anyone can join on our Discord, focus on spiritually connecting people through games and topical interests. For those who have been with us a couple of months and are daring enough, feel free to lead a new community channel with 2 to 3 people hanging out a month. Just submit your idea as a community channel ticket in the Discord. These communities are just so important because Jesus says in Matthew 18:20, "For where 2 or 3 are gathered in my name, I am there among them." So please get involved. If you want to learn more about VRMO Church, a couple of websites to check out is mmo.church and vrchurch.org. Feel free to take a picture so you can view the links later in your photos to find out more about us. There is a donation button if you feel led to donate in big or small ways to the vision of season 5, but most importantly, there is a button at the top where you can join our Discord. It's a group chatting program where you can get all your questions answered and get connected to people outside of the Sunday services. Examples of questions we are continuing to mull over are: how do we help people to regain the energy to engage with life and develop themselves to the fullest? Or how can we cultivate community, helping people to be seen and heard in these virtual environments? Or even, what's the simplest form of church we can express? So don't be afraid to join the server if you're not a Christian. As long as you're nice, we really enjoy conversing with people from all different backgrounds. As worship comes up next, I ask that all of you prepare your hearts to be able to receive today's sermon from the pastor. May God bless all of you richly and speak to your heart what you need to hear today. Thank you so much for coming.
Breathe deep, every breath I take is from you. Hope is running through my veins, filling up my heart with joy.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I don't know what part of the world or what time it is where you're from, but I want to say welcome to Virtual Reality Church. My name is DJ Soto. I'm one of the pastors here at VR Church, and it's so good to see everyone. Hope you're doing well. If you're not doing well, I hope that the service today encourages your faith, because I know, man, some tough times going on in many ways. And so I hope that you're encouraged today. It's so good to see you. What's up, Ian, buddy? Good to see you, man. How things going in your part of the world? Kalibo, are you from Texas? Is that TX is down from Texas? What's up, man? Good to see you too. All right. We're going to jump into the sermon here in just a minute, but I want to say hello to those watching on Twitch. You see Aaron flying in the sky. He's our Twitch streamer. What's up, Twitch? Crystal, Starfire, or Starchild, Maisie Love, whoever else is on Twitch. Maybe Aaron, you can let me know who's on there. I should bring up the chat. That should be an easy thing to do. Maybe I'll have that next time. I can read what you guys are saying. And see what else. Oh, yes, Zeke is over on Big Screen VR. He's streaming this service over on Big Screen. That's crazy, man. You just planted a church in like 2 seconds. What's up with that, man? I love that. So, Zeke, man, I don't know if you got a crew over there. If you're by yourself, man, just keep doing your thing, man. For the longest time, I did VR church to an empty room. I did the whole thing. One or two people would swing by. So just keep doing your thing. If no one shows up, if you're consistent, I think that Big Screen VR streaming church will, man, that'll grow. So hats off to Zeke over there. And if people are big screeners, go hang out with Zeke sometime. He's streaming the service over there. I think you guys would enjoy that. All right. Anything else, Pastor Alina? I can't think of any other major announcements. But let me know if I'm missing something. I feel like I am, but I'm sure we'll remember before the end of the service. Okay, let's jump right into the sermon today. If we can go to the next slide. There's a couple things that I want you guys to look at. Let's see here. You might have to go. Yeah, just keep cycling all the way through a pass. Yeah, this one right here. So check this out. At VR Church, our particular style of church is to read one chapter of the Bible every week. And we've been doing that for the longest time. We'll read chapters that no one reads, and maybe we don't even know what it means, or we give our best interpretation of what it means. But we just like diving in all parts of the scriptures. Asking questions, providing interpretations, asking you what you think what the interpretation is. And we just have just been enjoying that journey. That's our style of church. And check it out, man. We've done quite a bit. All the books that are crossed out are books we've already read through, starting back in Luke and John and Acts. And someone says, why did you start in Luke? Well, I think at the time, way back in 2017, that's where we started. And we just started going chapter by chapter. We did skip Romans and Corinthians because we wanted to go to the epistles. So, and then we worked all the way through to Jude, coming back to Revelation. So now we're going to go all the way back to Matthew, read through Matthew, Mark, Romans, Corinthians, and then back to Revelation. So that's crazy. I think as a church, we've existed long enough to, we're probably going to finish the New Testament here in the next year or two. So that's amazing. I haven't calculated it out. You math. Politicians can probably correct me on the exact time of when we'll finish the New Testament. And then I think, I don't know, we're going to go to the Old Testament, I guess, and go start at Genesis 1:1. I don't know. We haven't gotten that far yet. So that's going to be Genesis 1:1 world build, the origins of the universe. That'll be crazy build. I'm going to love that one. I think the world build team would as well. All right, Octane, you can go to the next slide. So we're going to be exploring the book of Matthew. And so I might need to do a pause here to because I need to fix a technical glitch. And so, Pastor Alina, do you mind just coming up and, you know, talking with the folks while I fix what's going on here? So, be 1 minute, I'll be right back.
It helps to have myself unmuted. Hello, everybody. I just want to extend my own welcome to everybody here via our church. So glad to join you. I tried to run up here. I just wanted to say hello, my own hello to everybody on Twitch. Crystal, Starchild, Macy Love. I'm not sure who else is there, but man, do I miss you guys. We need to find a way to catch up soon. I always get this face-to-face time with everybody here that joins us in person. And I just don't get enough face-to-face time with all of you. But really excited for today's sermon. Yes, how are you doing, Jaden? Pastor Soto here is going to take us on a little journey. We always go through these journeys. I'm not sure if you're new here at VR Church. He's going to take us on a journey through Matthew 1. And
yeah,
got it all sorted out.
It sound good? Everything look good here? My audio
sound good.
Okay?
Look good. Looking sharp. All I right. Like your new dress. You're
oh, thank you.
Booted up a little day. Differently today. Yeah.
Yeah.
Looking good.
All right. Well, let's jump into the book of Matthew. So before we start, I don't know if let me just unmute the microphones for everyone here in just a second. I need some feedback. You can type it out to me. You can raise your hand and I'll come over to you. I just want to hear some of your favorite TV shows, drama, sitcoms. You know, these are not necessarily my favorites, but, you know, lately we've watched Arrested Development and Cowboy Bebop and who's got one? Eric, what's one of your favorite ones?
Kim's Convenience. Just finished
Kim's Convenience. Has anybody seen that one? Kim's Convenience? Wandering, did you have one? I thought I might have saw your hand raise.
Mandalorian.
Yeah, that's a great one. I got to get into that one. Mandalorian. How about you, Kalibo? Anything?
Man,
any favorite shows?
The Office.
Which one? The Office. Yes.
The Office. Yes.
A classic. Very good. What about you, Matthew?
Friends.
All right. Sentinel One just typed out to me Star Trek. Aaron Crystal says Friends on Twitch. All right. Who else am I missing? Pastor Lini, maybe you can ask. Might have Jake the Snake. If you're in Overflow, you might have to text it to me because I don't think we can talk. You're
Jake
on the other
snake.
Side of the.
Jake the Snake. What do you have? What show? Curb Your Enthusiasm. Curb the Enthusiasm. Did I say that right?
Enthusiasm.
I haven't seen that one.
All right. All right. Well, I'm just going to go ahead and mute all just to make sure we have no, you know, background noises and everything like that. But the reason I was bringing that up is because when you watch your favorite show, especially if it's a complicated one where there's just a lot of characters and interwoven narratives and all of those types of things, it's important to keep up with the episodes, right? Like you wouldn't want to come in episode 7 of The Mandalorian. Man, what's going on? Who's this character? Why did this happen? I'm confused. And isn't kind of not necessarily irritating, but I'm just saying like somebody comes in the middle of a season and it's like, who's that? Like, well, it's the main character. Well, where are they? Oh, that's the bad guy. You know what I mean? So it's kind of like, wow, there's this narrative that the show writers are creating for us to understand season by season, episode by episode, a full narrative. So with that in mind, I want you to think of the book of Matthew as an epic miniseries. There is a story to be told. And as a matter of fact, we're going to be calling it episodes. So today we're in chapter 1 or episode 1 of Matthew. And here's what I want you to think about. Sometimes the first episode is setting things up for what's coming. So oftentimes in VR Church, I love the epistles because like every chapter is so like life application. But sometimes you read scripture and you're like, oh, I don't, you know, it didn't seem really impactful to me. By the way, I think there's some impactful things to definitely be a part of in the scripture. But I want you to think about this as episode 1, maybe even a prequel, if you will. And as we go from episode to episode, here's my main encouragement to you, that you would make sure to keep up with the episodes. So I encourage you to come back every week. If you can't come back every week, check out our YouTube channel to watch the services. If you don't have time to watch the services, Google Matthew and read that channel. Different ways to keep up with the episodes, because as we keep going, and I know life's busy, you have to go travel for work and there's school and whatever. If you come in later, you're going to miss the full picture
that Matthew is painting. And there is something beautiful in the narrative, and he's going to build on it little by little. So this episode one, or a prequel, he's introducing the main characters. He's setting the stage. He's kind of giving us a bird's eye view of what's going on. And what's going on is a special message that God wants to give each and every one of us. This episode is culminating to that moment where God delivers a message to you, like literally you and I. And so we're going to go read about that. And we're going to read about the birth of Christ. And I know we just did Christmas, but we're also going to read some genealogies. How did Christ even get here? So let's go ahead and go to episode one of Matthew. So everyone follow me to my right, to your left. Let's see here. Pastor Lena, if you don't mind turning on some participation, could you use some help reading? My fourth sermon for today, so definitely could use some help to save my voice if you guys don't mind. Feel free to interact with the environment. Come check out the world build. Why is this baby lying here? We're about to explain that here in just a second. I'll go ahead and start out, and I could definitely have some use some help reading. Episode 1, Matthew chapter 1, here's how it begins. These are the ancestors of Jesus Christ, a descendant of King David and of Abraham. All right, we got some main characters starting out in this episode. We're introduced to the main character. We're going to be talking about the life of Christ through the eyes of Matthew. Matthew was a follower of Christ, and he wrote down the things that he saw and he heard, and he has an amazing story to tell. But he wants to back up a little bit before we get to the life of Christ and the feeding of the 5,000s and the death and the burial and the resurrection and the miracles and all these wonderful stories that we hear, all these amazing stories. Let's read about the ancestors of Christ. He's a descendant of King David. You may know of King David from David and Goliath, a legendary story. Even use that today in sports like David versus Goliath. And also, don't forget about this main character called Abraham. Abraham really is where this all started, when the divine interacted with man and Abraham. And he told Abraham something really powerful. He said, all nations will be blessed through you. So even from the very beginning, thousands of years ago, this message comes down from God to this one guy named Abraham. And he says, I choose you. You're the chosen one. By the way, isn't that interesting? With a lot of our mini series, we have like the chosen one. I just saw the Matrix 4, by the way, the chosen one. You see that all throughout like Star Wars and Lord of the Rings and, you know, all those types of things. And you have this aspect of people who are chosen for a time, for a place to do something very powerful, not because they're, you know, better than anyone else, but because they have a destiny to fulfill. And so to Abraham, God told him all nations. You're in China, you're in the Middle East, you're in Africa, you're in South Africa. All nations will be blessed through you. So right off the bat, we see that the divine wants to interact with us humans, with all of us. It doesn't matter if you're here in America, or it doesn't matter if you're in Hong Kong, God's love knows no bound. So that's the beginning. Matthew chapter 1, these are the ancestors. Let's head down here. I'm going to read a couple more, and then I'll have you read. Because there was a lot of people that were in the line of Christ. Well, Abraham was the father of Isaac. Isaac was the father of Jacob. Jacob was the father of Judah and his brothers. I would love to spend time talking about all these individual people in many ways. There's such a beautiful, powerful story behind them that was good. And you also see some epic failure. Like you would think the lineage of Christ would come through some holy line, untarnished. You know, think like the King of England, King and Queen of England, right? Very proper and pious. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying, you know, we would think it would come through that. But man, God used just ordinary, regular people. Some of them did good. Some of them did bad. Some of them did really bad. And it just shows that God is going to accomplish his purpose, no matter if people mess up, no matter if people do it right, no matter if things go good and things go bad. I mean, Abraham, he messed up quite a bit. God still used him. There's a little lesson there for all of us. God, the destiny that God has for you cannot be tarnished by some things you would say, like, oh, Pastor, you don't need me. I failed. I'm an epic failure. Well, maybe so were many of these. These weren't like saintly men, perfect men. Let's go ahead and keep reading over here. Judah was the father of Perez and Zerah. Tamar was their mother. Perez was the father of Hezron. Hezron was the father of Aram. And I love that the scripture includes women. In church history, there's often been an anti-women sentiment, but that's not the case when it comes to the spirit of Christ. As a matter of fact, Christ and Paul destroy that preconception that, you know, the male is over here and the female is down here. No, we're in equal standing before God. And I love that inclusion. But let's go ahead down here and read some more. Because the writer, it's not just random things. He's not just historical record, although that's part of it. I believe that there's something that the writer is trying to accomplish. Let's go check out these guys. I like this guy with the hard hat right here. Let me have a couple of readers here. Let me have someone read 4, 5, and 6 for me.
Chad, hello. Chad, hello. If you're on the air
now. Can you hear me?
For 4, 5, and 6?
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you so
much.
And
by the way, just let me say this before everyone reads. You're going to butcher the names, and it's okay. Just work through it. I butcher the names. Don't worry about it. Just do your best. And so thank you, Chad. I don't know if Chad's still there. And Chad, it looks like you might be muted. Might have to reboot that, Alina, maybe?
Okay. I'll close this out and reopen it in just a moment, Chad. All right. There you go.
You
look good.
Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Yep. All right, cool. Abram was the father of Amminadab. Amminadab was the father of Nahshon. Nahshon was the father of Salmon.
And you can read verse 5 over there if you don't mind.
Okay. Salmon was the father of Boaz. Moab was his mother. Boaz was the father of Obed. Ruth was his mother. Obed was the father of Jesus.
All right. Thank you so much, Chad. All right. And I know these men are looking nice and stately, nice and, you know, we're straight here and very polished. And I'm sure there was some good in their life, but there was also some bad. They're humans. And it's amazing to see that at any point this lineage could have been broken, but God continued it through the end, through Jesus. And I would love to spend time on each one. We could like do a full sermon on a handful of these names. But Rahab is so interesting. That's a story that we're going to need to do when we go to the Old Testament. Rahab, yeah, I'm just going to be just completely transparent with you. She was a prostitute. She was a prostitute in the city of Jericho. And when there was war broke out, she hid some Israeli spies and she joined with them. And what is amazing to me is to see that God can use anybody. Look, she is written down over here. My bad. She is written down in the ancient scriptures in this hall of fame, almost a person who lived this life over here in Jericho. And God has included her, a foreign outcast prostitute. Hey, you come here, you're going to be the lineage of Jesus Christ. I love that, Rahab. We could talk about Ruth. Ruth is an amazing story. There's a book of the Bible called Ruth, and we're gonna go check that out someday in the future because there are some powerful stories about Ruth. The power of women in this lineage is very powerful. So we're going to go over here because over here we have Jesse was the father of King David. David and Goliath. All right. And David was a, let's see if I can, I don't think I can teleport there, but David was a king of Israel. The scripture says he was a man after God's own heart. But David wasn't exactly clean all the time. He had some scandal. We're going to read about that here at the bottom where it says David was the father of Solomon. Solomon was wrote much of the Proverbs. And he is considered to be one of the wisest kings, although in some ways he was very unwise. But his mother was the widow of Uriah. And we could spend time here talking about how theologians probably can't explain that this should not be in the scriptures. See, David married Uriah, but David married Bathsheba, and she was the widow of Uriah. And so what that means is that there was a big battle David was supposed to go to, and he killed that general so that he could be with his wife. It was a scandal. I mean, you think of scandals here in modern times. I mean, this was the scandal of its time. And Solomon was born from that. And in a way that I can't explain, in a way that is beyond just me to even articulate, man, God can even use mistakes. You would think at this point in the lineage, it's done, it's over. But God takes a mistake and redeems it. Some of you think you are a mistake. Well, my parents didn't plan on having me. You know, my parents weren't even married, or maybe I don't even have parents. You know, I just was born and adopted. Man, you are not a mistake. God can take that in ways that I can't explain to you in the interaction of Jesus Christ, just as he did with Solomon and who his mother was, the widow of Uriah. It's interesting that the Bible made sure you knew who she was. She was the widow of Uriah. Okay, let's see here. All right, King David, let's keep moving over here. Keep things moving. Come over this hill. May have another reader. Let's have someone read verses 7, 8, and 9. And you might be muted, Elena, if you're talking.
Eric, thank you.
Hello.
A few technical issues over here, but yes, Eric, you should be good to go. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Solomon was the father of Rehoboam. Rehoboam was the father of Abijah. Abijah was the father of Asa. Asa was the father of Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat was the father of Jehoram. Jehoram was the father of Uzziah. Where did you want me to stop?
You can do verse 9 as well.
Okay. Uzziah was the father of Jotham. Jotham was the father of Ahaz. And Ahaz was the father of Hezekiah.
Might as well finish it off, 10 and 11.
Hezekiah was the father of Manasseh. Manasseh was the father of Amos. Amos was the father of Josiah. Josiah was the father of Jeconiah, and brothers born at the time of the exile to Babylon.
Ah, yes, the exile to Babylon. Daniel, the book of Daniel. Again, we're referencing the Old Testament. We'll go there at some point. Their exile to Babylon. The lineage continues. Again, partly a historical record, but partly you're going to be at the end. There's a message that God wants you to know about through all these generations. And let's go continue this a little bit further along. Come over here. Watch your step. Don't fall in the chasm. Have you ever heard that in church before? I don't think so. In our Rust church, we had to wait for the helicopter to stop attacking another base before we started church today. So the kind of unique thing of the multiverse. All right, let's have someone read 12, 13, and 14. What's the writer leading us to? He's leading us somewhere.
Yeah, Matthew, let's have a reader. Okay, Google.
Can you hear me?
Yes, thank you. Sorry to interrupt. I thought we were ready.
So what do you want me to read? 12 and what?
12, 13, and 14.
After the elects, Johiah was the father of Stelis. Stelis was the father of Abud. Abud was the father of Elikum. Elikum was the father of Azor. Azor was the father of Zadok. Zadok was the father of Akam. Akam was the father of Elud.
Very good, man. Those are tough pronunciations. Good job. The lineage continues. Elud was the father of Eleazar. Father of Than. Than was the father of Jacob. And here we go. This is where the writer was heading. And then he's also taking us even further. Was the father of Joseph, who was the husband of Mary, the mother of Jesus Christ, Messiah. So the lineage has come all the way to this point. Now the writer wants to let us know some more things. So let's head over here through the light rays. And we'll come, we'll keep coming over here to the side. Oh, watch out, chat, for Grim, don't fall. Hope, I think you're okay. So keep swinging around. And I kind of love this build because it just kind of has that feeling of just navigating through time, generations through time. And here in verse 17, we see this. It says, these are 14 of the generations from Abraham. All nations are going to be blessed to King David. And 14 generations from King David's time to the exile. And 14 from the exile, Christ. Now, let's go read a little bit about the birth of Christ. Now, we spent some time in Christmas on Luke chapter 2, but Matthew has a different perspective. He has some behind-the-scenes drama that I don't believe we saw in Luke chapter 2. Let me have someone read verse 18 for me.
Wandering.
Can you hear me?
Yes, thank you so much.
These are the facts concerning the birth of Jesus Christ. His mother, Mary, was engaged to be married to Joseph. But while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant by the Holy Spirit.
All right, thank you, Wandering. Let's do a little timeout real quick. You should definitely come get a close look. I believe Alice drew this in Paintbrush or Google, or I don't know the app. But this was hand-drawn in virtual reality. And I think it's an amazing, look at the strands of hair is what I'm trying to say. I think Alice did an amazing job kind of painting this scene here. Beautiful. Correct me if I'm wrong. I think that's what it was, Alice who did that. I believe it was on Paintbrush of some type.
Yes, it was definitely Alice. She does amazing, beautiful work. She's done other little things that were just hand-drawn just for us.
Yeah, I love it.
Amazing.
So these are the facts, like Wandering said, concerning the birth of Christ. Mary is engaged to Joseph. Now, check out this part of the scripture. It says, but while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant by the Holy Spirit. All right, so now you kind of have to put yourself in the story. You have to put yourself in Mary's shoes. Mary is very young, and, you know, one day, and I'm dramatizing here a little bit, so don't mind the drama. Dramatization. She looked down. She was like, wait a minute. Yeah, must be a little bit of carbs here. I got a little belly going on here. Next few weeks, she was like, oh, what's happening here? Something's happening. An angel came and told her that she was pregnant. She would be delivering the Son of God. He was here to save the world. And an angel told her this. Now, imagine that going to your fiance, Joseph, and saying, honey, again, dramatization. Hey, can you sit down for a second? I got to tell you something. So you see this belly here, I've been covering it up. So an angel of the Lord came to me. I got a good reason. An angel of the Lord came to me, told me I was pregnant with the Son of God. Now, be fair, be honest. Maybe most of us would say you're crazy and I don't believe you. Who'd you cheat with me on? Who'd you cheat on with? And so that was what happened. And you say, well, how do you know Joseph was like that? How do you know he didn't believe her? Well, let's go read it. We got some drama in here in the story. Follow me over here to this building. Come over here to the left and through the door. I mean, I don't blame him. Would you? Come on, Mary. You can better story than that. Who was it? Who'd you cheat on with? I want to know a name. I want to take care of this guy. Let somebody read verse 19 for me, because this shows poor Joseph. He thought his fiance is going nuts.
I couldn't imagine. Linda, if you could please. Linda Souza?
Can you hear me?
Yes, thank you very much.
And Joseph, her fiancé, being a man of stern principle, decided to break the engagement, but to do it quietly, as he didn't want to publicly disgrace her.
All right, so in other words, thank you, Linda. In other words, Joseph was a good guy. He wasn't going to make an embarrassment out of her. He wasn't going to, like, you know, make rumors. And, you know, he just wanted to do it quietly. He was a man of stern principle. Another translation says he was a devout man. He was a good guy. But clearly, you can tell he wasn't buying a word of it. Would you? You can come up with a better story than that. So we're going to get divorced. They were going to break off the engagement. Being engaged back in that day was like being married. So that's why you see the word divorce sometimes in the translations. But somebody read verse 20. Something changed his mind. And actually, let's have you read verse 20 and 21, the next reader.
Uh-oh, this is going to set off one of my devices. But Alexa, if you could please read. oh my God, it's going to echo from my device here. I'll just, yes, please. Alexa, 20 through... 23. Oh, we've got some music playing. there's music playing. Alexa, stop the music.
I can do it. Alexa, I see you there. It looks like you're muted, though. You might have to restart. Oh, my Alexa's on now. Alina, you might have to turn it off and on for Alex.
Okay, for Alex, let's do that. There we go, Alex. All right. And did that help? Oh, it still shows you muted. The mute button on the top of your wheel, is it red, Alex? And if it is, would you please click on it? And it like one more time, I will turn maybe. It off. Let me turn it off one more time. Oh, I think I see her. I do. Is this Alexa right here? Oh, wrong person. I'm looking at the wrong person. I'm sorry. Okay.
Yeah, she's over here. Yeah.
Okay.
She
doesn't look on. Yes, let's go to the next person. Okay. And that is Jame. Jame in the house. I know you're here. There she is.
What's up? What am I supposed to say?
23.
Verse
23?
20 and 21.
Or
2021.
20 and 21? Okay. As he lay awake considering this, he fell into a dream and saw an angel standing beside him. Joseph, son of David, the angel said, "Don't hesitate to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her has been conceived by the Holy Spirit. And she will have a son, and you shall name him Jesus," meaning Savior, "for he will save his people from their sins."
All right. Thank you so much, Starfire. So as he lay awake, in other words, he couldn't go to sleep. Man, have you ever had those nights where something bothered you, make you so upset? Maybe it was relationship oriented, keeping up at night. The mind's just racing. He was probably like, "You're making up stories. How dare she do that?" As he lay awake, couldn't go to bed, fell into a dream. An angel came. I don't know if it was the same angel. And you can kind of see this beautiful picture that Alistair to kind of represent what's happening. Joseph's in a little kind of trance here. Angel said, "Man, don't hesitate. Take Mary as your wife," because what she said was true. And I don't know what was in Joseph's mind. The Bible doesn't describe his emotions or his thoughts, but I imagine it was maybe a bit of a relief, a bit of fear. What's this like spirit angel doing here talking to me? And the other side of it is like, oh, she wasn't lying? You got to be kidding me. So sure enough, it says here that he took Mary as his wife. Verse 22 and 23. Before we get to that, the angel said, "And Mary will have a son. You shall call his name Jesus," meaning Savior, "for he will save his people from their sins." And the writer showing us that the love of God has as through all these generations, the good, the bad, the horrific, to deliver this message that God wants to save us from our sins. Man, all the junk and the failure and the regret and the shame, man, God wants to get rid of all that. His name means Savior. He's not here to judge the world. He's not here to throw lightning bolts. He's here to save it, to forgive us, to release us, to redeem us, to buy us back. And it just keeps getting better, by the way. Let me have someone read 22 and 23.
Eric, am I on the air? Is that me?
Eric? Okay. Yes, sorry. Muted. Oh, why can I not?
Fulfill God's message through his prophets. Listen, the virgin shall conceive a child. She shall give birth to a son, and he shall be called Emmanuel, meaning God is with us.
All right, I love this part of the scripture here. Especially here at the end, He shall be called Emmanuel. And what does Emmanuel mean? It means God is with us. And that's what I was trying to say at the beginning of the episode, that the writer, yes, it's a historical record, but yes, it's a miraculous account of how the through generations, the lineage of Christ has gone through the good, bad, the horrific, and it has come to let you know that God wants to save us from our sins, and also to let you know here at VR Church that God is with you. And if you forget anything today, just don't forget this concept. You know, I've been talking, we've been reading, God's with you. The very end, through the thick and thin, he's with you. Through good times, he's with you. Through bad times, he's with you. Well, Pastor, it doesn't seem like it. How can God be with me if things are falling apart? I can't explain that, but he's with you. He's with you because he loves you. He wants to elevate us out of the sin and all the shame and all the regret and all the failure. He is with us. You know, and I love that because sometimes it seems like, you know, well, God's an angry God and he's come to bring judgment to the world. Well, no, in John 3, it says God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world. He didn't do that. He didn't send him into this world to condemn it, but to save it. And you see that reflected here in that God is with us. And that's what he wants to let everyone in here know, that God is with you. And I'll go ahead and read the final one here. And it says this. This is the end of episode one for this epic series that we're going to be reading on with the book of Matthew. And here's the final thought here to wrap up episode one. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel commanded and brought Mary home to be his wife. But she remained a virgin until her son was born. And Joseph named him Jesus. All right, my friends, the stage is set. The characters have been introduced. The story is about to launch into some amazing things. We're going to meet some amazing characters. But we haven't even gotten connected with the disciples. Who are those guys? Peter, James, and John. Historic church leaders, church fathers, saints that I guess some of us call them. We haven't even introduced them. That's fun when we start to meet them. When Jesus interacts with the disciples for the first time. But before we get to that, chapter 2, let me be honest with you, it's a little dark. Chapter 2, it's kind of like, I don't know if you saw The Mandalorian, where, you know, they wanted to capture or kill the baby Yoda. And in the same way, in chapter 2, King Herod wants this Jesus baby dead. And so soldiers are going to be sent to kill him. That's just a little trailer for what's about to come. It's going to get a little dark next week, but that's part of the narrative of what happened. And we're going to see some beautiful things that come out of that. Well, my friends, follow me over here towards the, we'll go back to the spawn area. Actually, you know what? Can we get a quick picture? This is just a really kind of beautiful sight over here. Can we all just do a timeout? I know we got a few minutes. Right, line up over here real quick. And moderators, you can start to unmute and stuff like that. I don't need to be in. Y'all can get in. I'm good.
Oh, no. Take the picture. No. I was going to get you in there. You're never in these.
I got in the last time. Get in there.
I'm going to keep a tally, scoreboard. We're like, okay. Okay.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. This is good. In 3, 2, 1. And let's see what we got. Pretty good. Let's do another one. If I can't see your eyeballs, you're not in the picture. 3, 2, 1. All right, let's do one more. I see everybody's face. Yeah, if I don't see you, there you go. Cat moved. They moved over a little bit. All right. There we go. And 3, 2, 1. And excellent. All right, let's go back over here to the spawn point. We'll go ahead and close in prayer. I don't know if Mr. Pete's here. Somebody, Mr. Pete, ping me if you're here to close in prayer. If not, perhaps Pastor Alina, you can get ready to close in prayer. And we'll go up this embankment over to the right. And let's go make a little prayer circle over here in the spawn area. So just where the seats are, kind of make a nice big prayer circle right here just to close in prayer. All right. And we look forward to getting back into episode 2 next week when he is hunted. Maybe we'll call it The Hunted, the name of that episode. I don't see Mr. Pete, so Pastor Elena, if you don't mind closing us in prayer. Then after we pray, guys, thanks so much. Church is over after we pray. Feel free to hang out. So, Pastor Elena.
Yeah, thank you. Father God, just thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your precious gift, your love, for looking out for us, even when we don't know you're there, for always being with us. Lord, we especially thank you that you are with us even when we turn our backs. You are constantly calling for us, following us, searching for us. And Lord, we just ask that, you know, anyone who's experiencing things in their lives where they feel like you're not with them, Lord, just a special something for them, just that they feel this, that they know this, that they know that you're caring for them. And, you know, just like here in Matthew 1, where it's going to get a little dark in Matthew 2, but it's all leading to this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful thing. Lord, we ask that you help give that hope to those that are struggling, that they know you are with them, that they will get through these dark times, and they will see whatever beautiful thing you have in store for them. We just thank you for this. We love you. We praise you, Jesus, every day. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Lena. Thanks, everybody. Have a great day.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.
Can you come to the end of me?
Personal prayer. At least,
yes, and thank you for joining us on Twitch. I actually am super excited that I could just drop down my mic and start speaking without having to reset my audio engine. So, as always, you guys have a nice week, and I hope to see you all. And hope it's smooth sailing from here.
Which one? Message I sent you while we were talking about Perez, who was also the son, whose mother was Tamar.
Bye bye.
Oh yeah. Isn't that wild? Yeah. God can just do anything.
Because Tamar was actually the daughter of Judah.
Oh yeah. Thank you, Bite Size.
Judah was also the father of.
You are very welcome. You guys are the reason I stream.
There you go.
The ancestors of Christ.
It's weak as all.
So
yeah, I saw that. Yeah.
Even rape and father-daughter and stuff.
That's really cool.
Quite
cool.
Wow.
Yeah, this is a church arcane.
In the book of Moses, Tamar.
Y'all have a good night.
I know, I came here last night. So she